It began with the forging of the strings, equal parts beautiful and dark. Then the brass, raw power filled with fire and fury. And the winds, divine masters of magic and color. Then the percussion crafted from the most sacred materials. And finally, the voices, wild spirits from the ether tamed by our necromancers. But now, the time has come to release one product to rule them all. With Hollywood Fantasy Orchestrator, you can create entire fantasy scores in seconds. With hundreds of presets crafted by the most skilled bards in the land, and the ability to customize or create your own, you'll have the power to instantly produce music in the style of Hollywood's greatest soundtracks. Only one question remains. What will you create?
Ryan Thomas of East West here, and welcome to the official walkthrough for Hollywood Fantasy Orchestrator, which is the final chapter in our Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra series. And this really is the grand finale that this groundbreaking series deserves, because it so beautifully unifies all these libraries in such an inspirational way. Now, if you're not familiar with how the Orchestrator engine works, it basically allows you to produce full soundtracks in seconds just by playing a few notes on the keyboard. And this iteration of Orchestrator is using all the instruments in Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra. So it just has this beautifully modern fantasy flavor. Now, we have so much to cover, so let's go ahead and just dive right in. Now, when you load up Orchestrator, you have a few different options. You can either start building a preset from scratch, which we'll show you how to do a bit later on in the video, or you can load up one of the pre-existing presets that you'll find across these various categories, which we'll also explain a bit later on in the video. So to load up a preset, just click on the category and then choose the specific preset that you want. So let's go ahead and load up Ancient Myth 01 and give it a listen. And then these keys down at the bottom are just key switches that allow you to mute or unmute the various instrument groups. Now, we'll get more into how to program these from the ground up a bit later on in the video, but for now, let's go ahead and start checking out the ensembles. And these are basically instrument stacks that have been very carefully arranged, so the chords are voiced very intentionally. And let's go ahead and start with the strings and choir sustains. And this is really just a magical sound. Now, this next one is one of my absolute favorites. It's got just such a vibey sound. Could be ideal for everything from comedy to suspense, and even has kind of a piratey vibe to it. And this next one, I think, is just a great all-around workhorse preset. It's going to be ideal for establishing that chord for other instruments to work off of. And full orchestra tremolo 01 is going to be ideal for suspense. And let's go ahead and do one more. This legato patch is fantastic when you need a really beefy melody. All right, next, let's check out the ostinatos. And these feel pretty good on their own, or you can spice them up with some string or brass melodies. And let's just start with the straight 16th notes. So here is the 16th notes 01 preset. And this next one is just going to be a 6/8 variation. Now, this one is one of the accented patterns, so you get a bit more rhythmic color with this one. And these eighth note patterns have a bit more of a relaxed pace. And let's do one more. This is one of the triplet ostinatos. All right, next, let's check out the scores. And these are really the heart and soul of what Orchestrator is all about. These are designed to be fully fleshed out soundtracks, so lots of color, lots of variation, very dynamic. And they're just a super effective way to absolutely rip through a project and end up with incredible results. Now, these are going to be ideal for film, television, commercial soundtracks, whatever, but I also think they're really well-suited for video game composing. And as you can see, you just have a ton of different presets to choose from. So let's go ahead and start with Blood and Sands 01. This is one of my absolute favorite presets. This one would be ideal for anything from pre-battle music to some more adventurous travel music. Next, let's check out Fortress 01, and this one has kind of a dangerous, perilous feel to it, so it could be ideal for a village raid scene or something along those lines. Next, we have Journey 05, and this one is going to be great for those big epic travel montages, and just has a generally adventurous feel to it. Now, I should point out that most of these presets are naturally going to favor certain kinds of chords or playing styles. So, for example, the one that we just did features those really prominent high string sustains on the middle note of the chord, and you could essentially play that like a melody. Whereas something like the Dwarven Secrets 01 preset works really well with just an open fifth in the left hand while the right hand plays a melody. So that's just something to be aware of. Definitely play around with these, try some different chords and playing styles and figure out what works best for each preset. So next, let's check out Nightfall 05. And all of the Nightfall presets are just pure magic. They really kind of capture the essence of fantasy. All right, next, let's check out Secrets of the Forest. And this one is pretty dark and mysterious, so it might be well-suited for a scene where a dark tale is being told by the village mystic. Now, just to show you how incredibly quickly and effectively you can score an entire sequence using Hollywood Fantasy Orchestrator, I've gone ahead and prepared this video game clip, and you've just got some gameplay here of the main character defeating this one enemy, and then it looks like he runs into a rock golem boss fight kind of thing. So we're gonna start with Out of Bounds 02. This is a great preset for battle music, for action music in general, and let's go ahead and mute the sound design. And then for the boss fight, let's go ahead and switch to Out of Bounds 01. So this is just going to keep the same feel, but it's going to give us a little bit of variation to keep things interesting. And then let's add some Wagner tubas from Hollywood Fantasy Brass just to get more of a buildup in this section. All right, and here's the entire sequence with the soundtrack we just made along with the sound design. Alright, so now what I'd like to do is build a preset from the ground up in real time, both so that you can see how easy it is and so that you can get a feel for the process. So the first thing you're going to want to do is load an empty preset, and then I just like to take it one section at a time. So let's go ahead and load the women's choir sustain ah and the men's choir sustain ah, because I just want this to be pure magic. And we're just going to put the women's choir up the octave. Now let's head over to the strings, and I'm going to load up the three dulcimer sustains. We're going to have these on the lowest note. We're going to bump them up an octave, and I want some movement in the dulcimer. So I'm going to turn on the sequencer, and we're going to pencil in a pretty simple pattern here. We just want an ascending sort of arpeggiated movement here. And then let's go ahead and have it descending here. And then we're just going to copy and paste this into the last half of this phrase. Now let's go over and load up some high strings. I just want these on a sustain as well. and I'm going to put these on the top note of the chord. So basically, this is making it so that I can play a melody with those strings just by changing the top note of what I'm playing. Now, the dulcimers were just a little bit too prominent, so I'm going to go ahead and turn those down a hair. And you can also adjust the velocities. You can do that globally, or you can do it individually. So I'm just going to adjust these down to about 25. Now, let's go ahead and add some lutes. And let's just go ahead and select the sustains. We're going to have these on the lowest note of the sequence. And I want to turn on the sequencer because I also want some simple movement in the lutes. So we're just going to do a little bit of up, and then we're going to be descending. And once again, I'm just going to copy and paste this into the second half of this phrase. And then finally, to round out the strings, let's add our low strings. And we're just going to have these in free mode. They're going to be playing the lowest note of the chord, and we're going to have these two octaves down. And then let's also go ahead and just turn the lutes down a bit, because I do want this preset to be on the more delicate side. So let's give it a listen. All right, so I think we're getting close, but I want to add some sparkle and some shimmer on the high end. And I'm going to reach for the crotales first. These are really just classic fantasy. And we're going to have these on the lowest voice in the sequence, but I am going to bump these up by two octaves. And I do want movement in the crotales, so I'm going to turn on the sequencer. And I actually want to go ahead and just copy and paste this data from the lute. So I'm going to copy all of it, and we're going to go over to the crotales, and then we're just going to paste it, and that's pretty much it. Now let's head over to the winds, and I'm going to load up some staccato high Irish whistles. We are going to put them on the top two voices and bump them up by an octave, and then I want these playing a sequence similar to the dulcimers. So I'm going to head over to the strings. We are going to copy all of this, and we're going to go back, and then we're going to paste it. But I actually want these to be repeating 16th notes, so I'm going to change the subdivision to 1/16th note. We're going to select all of these, and I'm going to shorten them. So now these are just 16th notes. And then I'm going to copy all of these to the note right beside them. So you're going to get this really cool 16th note pattern. And because we have two voices, I'm going to, again, select all of these. I'm going to copy them. And we're going to head over to voice two and paste them. So now let's go ahead and give it a listen. So that is Hollywood Fantasy Orchestrator, and we really just barely scratched the surface of it in this walkthrough. There are literally hundreds of other presets to explore. We're periodically adding new preset expansions, and the flexibility of the engine itself is just endlessly inspiring. Now, just to be clear, Hollywood Fantasy Orchestrator is not a standalone product. All five Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra libraries are required in order to run it, and all five licenses must be active. So you can either purchase the Hollywood Fantasy Orchestra bundle, and the Orchestrator license will be included with that, or you can just become a Composer Cloud Plus subscriber. And it really is just on the bleeding edge of modern fantasy soundtrack composition. So if you liked this content, don't forget to like the video, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future content. That's all for now. Thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.